Press is being very vocal right now as well with her teammates, urging them on. Right in front of the Stanford bench. They don't like it at all. The 09 National Championship Trophy is going home to Chapel Hill. Hear that sound like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now. Nice ball inside to Press. Press one on one. The shot. Goal! Christen Press.
Space for the cross. Morgan lets it go. The doorstep, Christen Press. As we see the potential for another goal, and Press puts number 8 on the board.
He's up for the challenge, knowing the pressures. Here's a shot off the crossbar and in. Hammered by Press. Christen Press.
So in the past, if I lost, I thought I was a loser, and if I won, I thought I was a winner. You held me down, but I got up, already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Me just every day deciding who I want to be and how I want to live, and then trying not to stray from that intent has brought me so much self-love. And the happier I am, the bigger my face is lit up. Like, that's an indicator of my performance that day. Satisfaction is a really hard thing to achieve, especially for me, and especially in this sport. You could always get better. But I don't dislike the fact that I can't be satisfied with how I am. I think that that's something that's been inside of me, and that is probably the biggest thing that has helped me achieve what I have and get to this place in my career. I think it's that itch, that burning desire to be better.
We see Christen Press getting up by the fourth official.
This is a team that should beat that Sweden team, Zubin, and that's what's going to be so frustrating for the U.S. players, because that loss just burns and burns for years and years. It never goes away.
Again, Pugh to lay it in. It must be pressed this time, yes. At last, she does have her goal on home territory.
Press. Good opportunity here. She's going alone here. And Press, and that's an own goal in the end.
As a kid, my mom used to say it's a mistake not to dedicate yourself to what you can be great at. And that's just always stayed with me, that there's always more I can do.